are Canadian and foreign speaking. We're going to be broadcasting this bilingually.
Absolutely. And we should start right now. I am Payne, c'est la jammeuse pour Charm City et Iron Wench pour les New Kids on the Block. I am Payne et première jammeuse, c'est Charm City qui prend le contrôle. Iron Wench sort du peloton également. Both jammers now eligible to score. Et c'est I am Payne qui approche le peloton. The Montreal Block, les bloqueuses de Montréal essaient de prendre le devant. Mais c'est I am Payne qui compte déjà des points. Elle en a trois. Elle arrête le jam et on lui accorde 3 points. 3 points for Charm City.
It was really great to see right at that start. They both had a good pace. They both had kind of a smart pack awareness as they didn't really give anyone any lead in. So, you know, opening jam, just kind of start. It's as though, again, they've met a couple of times. They're just kind of feeling each other out, just getting a sense on the track, seeing which way they want to take it.
Yeah, they know each other, and they know that it's going to be close.
Yes.
So right off the bat, you know, it's going to be a smooth yet hard bout. And this is Holly Gohardley for the Charm City Rollers taking lead jammer. Georgia W. Tush stuck at the back of the pack for the New Kids on the Block. And they are just not letting her move an inch. Actually, Holly Gohardley is right back in there scoring points. Smack Daddy recycles her, but she fell, so Holly Gohardley could re-enter right away. Holly Gohardley makes it across. 4 points, one, no pass, no penalty, so that's 4 points on her. Georgia W. Tush still not out of the pack, stuck behind two Charm City blockers, namely number two. That was Ochit. And already, Holly Gohardley is scoring again. Recycled at the back, she calls it off. Georgia W. Tush, I think, scored no points. 3 more points for Charm City and nothing for Montreal, which brings us to 10-0.
Well, that was interesting. As you saw in the pack right there, you had Battery Operated, who was doing a great bit of defense. You had that four wall of Charm City just kind of moving, shifting around. And you had, again, you had Battery Operated out the front, just kind of maintaining speed, understanding, moving individuals around, becoming, again, those eyes to that wall, which is interesting. We're seeing a lot of that. One person just out in front skating backwards, really communicating well.
And Iron Wench qui prend les devants. Iron Wench, première jammeuse pour les New Kids de Montréal. Et pour Charm City, on a 2A, on a Battery Operated. Mm-hmm. Et c'est Iron Wench qui est première jammeuse. Elle approche le peloton. New Kids ralentissent la cadence. Iron Wench rentre dans le peloton, prend ses points, tourne les hanches autour de la bloqueuse, prend ses points. Les premiers points pour Montréal. Montreal's First Blood, 2 points, 0 for Battery Operated.
And we talked a minute ago about how they just, again, were, like we said, getting a sense of each other. And it seems like now things are starting to break apart a little bit.
Yeah.
Charm City trying to make that little bit more push, starting out a little bit more aggressively. And Montreal's not a team to ever shy away from contact. But it seems like right now, again, they're just setting a pace. And I wonder if that's going to be the thing that we're going to see as we go throughout this game. Calm, cool Montreal.
Well, this is what they've been working for.
I dare to
As
dream.
As a matter of fact, on a I am Payne qui est première jammeuse pour Charm City et Maliwana, une nouvelle jammeuse pour Montréal qui est sortie du peloton également. Les deux jammeuses, both jammers can now score. Montreal making a big wall at the back. I am Payne sees Maliwana coming. Does she pick up any points? I think that's a
two.
Two for Montreal. A late call for I am Payne as she got zero.
She did. She's definitely having a discussion with the referees right there. She came in very quickly, called it. But as we've been talking about through the weekend, you have four whistles. You've got until the fourth. And on the outside, you had a clear lane. Jammer's able to get around, picks up two on the pass before that fourth whistle is done.
That's right. The moral of the story is don't stop believing.
It's the moral of every story with you, Patrick.
And when Iron Wench, we have Iron Wench for the New Kids on the Block. Et c'est knock and futz pour Charm City. Les deux jammers. Oh, c'est la course des jammers. A jammer race. Knock and futz. Look at that. Overtakes Iron Wench. We don't say that very often. And Iron Wench calls it off. Iron Wench s'est fait dépasser par knock and futz et arrête le jam pour ne pas donner des points.
I had the privilege of watching Charm City play within the last few weeks, actually. And knock and futz was very effective. She started out a little slow, but she picked up that speed. And she has that ability now, as she's had before, but really starting to shine where she can kind of get through, get quickly, and just edge that lead out. So not as though she gets out first, but she makes up and compensates. And then you saw right there, just have to call it before any point scored. You don't want to lose any ground. We have 12 points for Charm City, Montreal at 3.
On a Meliwana pour les New Skids, et c'est I Am Payne, la capitaine de Charm City All-Stars. Et c'est Meliwana, première jammeuse pour les New Skids. I Am Payne getting around Cheese Grater. Et ça passe pour I Am Payne. Meliwana est en tête. Elle approche du peloton. Les New Skids ralentissent la cadence pour qu'elle rattrape le plus vite. Et si on envoie Cheese Grater en avant pour être la bloqueuse offensive. Et Meliwana prend 2.2 points for Meliwana, 0-4 Charm City and I Am Payne.
It's interesting right now as we sit. This is an interesting game. I think a lot of people are interested in it. As I can see right now, the crowd is full, but not nearly as loud as they've been for the last three or four games. I wonder if right now action is low, everything's calm, and they're just waiting for that kind of casual build, because it seems the skaters are that way too. There's not a frantic nature. Nobody's trying to get that big push at the outset like some of the teams are. And it's interesting. It's just kind of this laid-back approach to roller derby right now.
Well, I don't think we have hit those moments that are game changers yet.
Absolutely not. Plenty of time.
Et on a Holly Gohardley. Non, c'est pas Holly Gohardley, c'est... c'est Holly Gohardley. La capitaine de Charm City, c'est Iron Wench pour les New Skids on the block. Holly Gohardley approche le peloton. Elle est première jammeuse. Non, elle ne sort pas du peloton. Elle arrête le jam. Elle prend seulement un point. 1 point only for Holly Gohardley.
And like you had said just a moment ago, Patrick, this is not a game, as of yet, where anybody is making those big efforts. Nobody's making that big explosive move. It's so far just a couple of points done, It's just trying to inch away. And that's what we see right now, Charm City putting 1, 2, 3 on the board as they go. 13 points. Montreal has 5. But, you know, we're 6 minutes in. Michael Jackson blissfully blaring in the background.
It's a Georgia Tush for the New Skids. On a I Am Payne encore une fois. Once again, I Am Payne for the Charm City All-Stars. I Am Payne, première jammeuse, dépasse tout le monde. Et c'est Georgia Tush encore prise dans la défensive de Charm City. I Am Payne s'apprête à entrer dans le peloton. Est-ce qu'elle comptera des points? Oui, elle dépasse le peloton. Mange-moi le cul, la dernière ligne. Et c'est fait. C'est un grand slam pour I Am Payne. A grand slam for I Am Payne. Georgia Tush still stuck in the pack, trying to exit the pack. Ooh, stuck behind Quick Shot Kitty and battery operated. Georgia Tush sort du peloton. On recycle I Am Payne à l'arrière du peloton et elle arrête le jam. Pourquoi continuer? Also, something that I noticed that's really interesting is very few penalties.
Yes, as a matter of fact, I've been keeping an eye on that. And again, early in the game, but we just have 3. Charm City's only got 2 right now. And we have Lady J for Montreal. And that first jam, actually, cut the track. Ochit and Just Carol. Tisk, tisk. So low penalties. We'll see what happens in this next one.
Yep. On Iron Wench pulling new skids, et c'est Holly Gohardley pour Charm City All-Star. C'est Iron Wench qui est première jammeuse. Elle sort du peloton. Une bonne avance sur... Et Holly Gohardley, here we go, perhaps a game changer. Le premier super jam du match, c'est Holly Gohardley qui s'en va au banc des punitions. Elle coupe la piste. Et facilement, elle saute la ligne. Iron Wench, 5 points à grand slam, grand slam pour Iron Wench. Évidemment, les New Skids arrêtent complètement. Surgical Strike, on envoie Surgical Strike en avant pour l'offensive. Iron Wench passe facilement, on la suit, mais elle passe quand même 5 autres points. Pour les New Skids, 5 more points for the New Skids. Passive offense on the New Skids on the block. They send off Greta Bobo. Et c'est Iron Wench qui passe encore une fois. Ouh, la dernière, elle passe à reculons backwards. Why not? If you can get through, no problem. 5 autres points pour les New Skids. Ça fait 15 points pour Iron Wench. 15 points so far. Surgical Strike, encore une fois, ouvre la porte pour Iron Wench. Et ça passe 20 points pour les New Skids, Iron Wench. There we go. Game-changing moment. We've been waiting for it.
We've been talking it up a little bit, and there it is. Not a lot of time left, about 40 seconds, but definitely enough time to get back through the pack as we see Montreal do just now.
Exactly. That's 25 points. I think she already passed Jess Carroll. Yep, she did.
Correct.
So 25 points, definitely that game-changing moment. Mais Holly Gohardley sort de la boîte des punitions. Elle est en piste. Elle a complété son passage initial. Elle peut maintenant compter des points. Est-ce qu'Iron Wench arrêtera le jeu? Oui, Iron Wench arrête le jeu juste à temps, right on time. She picked up 3 points. Holly Gohardley was about to score, but she got nothing.
Indeed, she was set out for that track cut, and that is what gave us that power jam, or as you say, if I roughly translate, premier super jam. which sounds fantastic if I say it that way. I like the ring of it. But that is what definitely cost the run right there. Montreal now up 33 points, Charm City at 19. Interesting as we see now Montreal, a little bit of separation, starting a traditional jam up at the pivot line.
Well, if they were traditions at one point, you know, throwing it back to retro. On a knock in face, qui est à l'avant du peloton. Meliwana s'en va au banc des punitions, et c'est un autre super jam, mais cette fois-ci pour Charm City et knock in face. Voyons ce qu'elle pourra faire. Elle doit compléter son passage initial. She must complete her initial pass. And it's done. Knock and Fuss, lead jammer, and the only jammer, la seule jammer en piste pour Charm City All-Stars.
They're definitely giving her an opportunity to work herself. The two in black holding back. That wall of four doesn't really cut completely across, just staggers out. Knock and Fuss able to take advantage of that and move through quickly.
Unfortunately, Smack Daddy s'en va au banc des punitions pour les New Skids. C'est trois bloqueuses pour les New Skids, deux pour Charm City. Et on arrête complètement. Oh. Et on avance. Chasing Amy, la dernière ligne de défense pour les New Skids. Knock and Futz pousse. Et ça passe. Ça fait 10 points. 10 points for Knock and Futz.
She's going to have some assistance as the pivot comes back in. So that might make a slight change. But we see now this is the third pass. Black just holding back. Knock and Futz having to work on her own.
Mais malheureusement, je pense que c'est Knock and Futz goes to the box herself. She cut the track. Elle coupe la piste également. Ça veut dire que Meliwana reviendra en piste et Knock and Futz sera envoyé au banc des punitions pour le même temps que Meliwana a servi. Meliwana back on the track. She has completed. She did not complete her initial pass.
No.
She will do so now. C'était son passage initial, donc pas de points pour Meliwana, mais maintenant Meliwana en piste compte des points.
Black holding the wall at the front, trying to block it up. Great defense again. They're holding that position. Getting a little bit of a bump. Nice move to the inside.
Meliwana pushing at the front. Quick shot, Kitty, the last one. She gets through. That's another 5 points for Meliwana. Montreal now pushing at 38, Charm City 29. Et on arrête le jam. Natural completion of the jam. That was 2 minutes.
Please.
38, Montreal 32, Charm City.
Interesting there at the very end, you saw Quick Shot Kitty. She gets bumped in the back, tries to throw her arms up, saying, look at this type of contact. The referees definitely were paying attention because I almost locked eyes with one, but I know they were looking at the track, as they often do. And it was right where that type of contact came in. You know, as we say, legal contact up to the moment of fourth whistle. Referees doing a fantastic job here, as they always do.
Et on a Iron Wench seul en piste pour les New Skids on the block parce que Knock and Fence est toujours au banc des punitions. Ça passe pour Iron Wench. Première jammeuse, elle a le contrôle pour les New Skids et c'est la seule joueuse en piste. On a Lady J, on envoie Lady J en offensive. Iron Wench gets through the pack et ça passe. Ça fait 5 points pour Iron Wench. Et les New Skids qui sont très patientes à l'arrière du peloton. Et maintenant, Knock and Fence revient en piste. Mais elle doit compléter son passage initial. Iron Wench, un autre grand slam. Ça fait 10 points. Et Knock and Fence toujours à son passage initial. She gets through now. And she is chasing Iron Wench. Iron Wench qui sûrement voudra compléter un autre passage avant d'arrêter le jam. Oh oui, she calls off the jam right after she tries and pulls that fancy hip trick that we've been seeing more and more of.
It's been definitely effective, though not so much there. We saw as she re-entered the track, the pack was split up, definitely decidedly controlled at the front and at the back, but it took about halfway around. They stopped again, and it was a rather specific jumble, so there wasn't any assistance. And Knock and Futz is definitely one of those who can find her own path, but is not afraid to get some assistance from her blocker. If they can just move a little bit out of the way, that, like we say, that quick spin hop that she's able to do, she can get through. She didn't get the opportunity at that particular moment.
But she sure tried. Et on a Georgia W. Tush pour les New Skids. Et c'est I Am Payne, la capitaine de Charm City All-Stars, qui est première jammeuse, lead jammer for the Charm City All-Stars. Georgia W. Tush completing, not quite. No! She is pushed to the floor. On envoie Georgia Tush au tapis et les bloqueuses de Charm City la reprennent. Mais c'est chose faite. Georgia Tush complète son passage initial. I Am Payne prend 4 points. Et arrête the jam, calls off the jam. She was chasing that jammer, looking for that fifth point, but she couldn't get it.
Absolutely. And we talked about penalties a little bit. And we can talk about it a little bit more as we do have a timeout. I do see Mr. Pistol, the coach for Charm City out there having a pleasant discussion.
Yeah.
We've seen him in the past. Anybody who's known and followed Charm City remembers the days of a more animated Mr. Pistol when his his face definitely matched the beautiful red on the shade of the Charm City jersey. But over the years, definitely calm demeanor, definitely been able to refocus. And in all honesty, Charm City as well changed. Their bench is much calmer, much more controlled. Yeah, it's a different team than two, three years ago.
Yeah, that's just what I was about to say, is that I think his demeanor represents the changes that they've been trying to make. Charm City was traditionally a very explosive, scrappy team, you know, who really went for it physically, was not afraid to get dirty. And I mean that in the most positive way.
There are a few. But it's as you're talking about, there's an emotional factor in any way that you play. And I think that they came in from such an emotional place that had a potential to override the skills and the training that they had worked for. And I think that they came back, worked to make that their particular focus, and it seems to show.
Yes, absolutely. I think last year, who I was discussing with the coach from the London Roller Girls, what's his name again? He's going to write on Twitter. Anyway, he was saying at the playoffs that he was hoping to meet with the Charm City, the more Mr. Hyde Charm City as opposed to Dr. Jekyll. Because it has been a team that had a tendency to be either completely focused and that would play roller derby extremely well, showcase their ability and win games, and then there would be the Charm City that could show up that was a frantic, penalty-heavy, emotional team. And unfortunately for London, the London Roller Girls, he got the Charm City that was focused, and they came in third at last year's playoffs, and they went to the championship for the third year in a row.
But definitely respectable in any guise that they do show up. We now have the conversation in a official timeout capacity, so we get to call this a Wicked Skatewear official timeout and possibly review. As soon as we get more information as to what is happening on the track, we will bring it to you here on WFTDA.tv. Thank you again for tuning in to day two of ECDX 2013 edition, 7 years going strong. Remember, save the date right around this time next year. We'll be back.
And while we've got time, Ben, why don't we run through the rosters? The Charm City Roller Girls have playing right now number 110, Yuvetta Work, number 14, Feral Cat, 16, 18, I Am Pain, number 187, Nuck and Futz, number 2, O Chip, number 26, Jess Carroll, 2, AA, Battery Operated, 34, Lady Kaboom, 415, Holly Gohardley, the Captain, 45, Quick Shot Kitty, number 6, Hitsburg, number 8, Free Radical, 91, Loretta Scars, and top 5, Susie Pow.
I think you just did that, so I would have to read Montreal and say, Mange moi le cul?
Exactly.
I've been working on that. Mm-hmm. Thank you for leading me through that before. That is number 1X. 2 is Little Mama. 289 is Cheese Grater. 33 is Demanda Lashing. 38, Ray Volver. 3X is Smack Daddy. Number 40 is Georgia W. Tush. 420 is Mel Iwana. 454 is Chasing Amy. 516, Iron Wench. 658, Surgical Strike. Number 8 is Just Bandit. 8080, Greta Bobo. 86, Lady J.
And we are just about to get back to the action.
All right, Bam Bam and Patrick, that was an official review that was taken by Charm City, and they wanted to contest what they thought was a low block against Montreal's jammer, and the referees did not actually overturn anything. They saw nothing, and so they called nothing.
Alors, l'équipe de Charm City qui voulait contester la décision d'un low block, d'un blocage aux jambes par les New Skids sur la jammeuse, mais la décision n'est pas renversée. Et malheureusement pour eux, on a Susie Pow, la jammeuse de Charm City, qui s'en va au banc des punitions pour un blocage au haut du corps. Et ça, ça laisse Iron Wench seule en piste pour les New Skids on the block. Iron Wench, the only jammer on track. Susie Pow sent to the penalty box for a high block. Évidemment, on a les New Skids qui arrêtent complètement de patiner. On envoie une bloqueuse en offensive. Et le pivot d'Iron Wench, ça lui vaut 5 points, 5 points for Iron Wench.
Again, a calm game is the phrase that I'm going to use. Well played. Only one penalty for anybody. Nobody has two penalties, and those are still low.
Et facilement, un autre passage pour Iron Wench, un grand slam, 5 points. 5 more points for Montreal. They are now at 59. Charm City, 36. Et Iron Wench passe à l'extérieur. Personne ne la surveillait. C'est Iron Wench. 5 autres points pour les New Kids on the Block. Il y a 4 bloqueuses pour les New Kids et 3 pour Charm City. C'est un léger avantage.
En masse, Montreal decides to move. Waiting for that potential. They get that push. Not quite able to do it, but she does it herself.
Aaron Wench, 5 autres points pour les New Kids on the Block. Et Susie Powell revient au jeu. Back on the track, Susie Powell for Charm City All-Star. She serves her minute. Mais elle doit compléter son passage initial. Et pendant ce temps, Aaron Wench va continuer de compter des points comme elle vient de le faire à un autre Grand Slam. Ça fait 20 points, 20 points so far for Aaron Wench. Susie Powell encore. Encore au banc des punitions, Susie Powell pour avoir coupé la piste. Another track cut for Susie Powell. So she is sent to the penalty box a second time in one jam. And in the meantime, Iron Wench is not going to complain and continue to score points.
I would think not, especially as that is a nice bit of a rally, as they say. Charm City at 36. Montreal is bumping the score up to 79. Now we have 13 minutes left to go. A lot of time left, but like we had said, we weren't seeing those big runs or rallies. We saw a little bit one earlier, but I think that definitely falls in that category.
Well, seems like they have come. Et maintenant, Montréal envoie Georgia W. Tush. Georgia W. Tush on the line for Montreal in a power jam situation. I betcha she wanted this. Oh, c'est Holly Gohardley qui s'en va au banc des punitions, elle aussi. Georgia W. Tush complète son passage initial. Smack Daddy au banc des punitions également. 3 bloqueuses pour Charm City, 2 seulement pour Montréal. Montreal working with 2 blockers, Charm City 3. Et Georgia W. Tush complète 7 points, 5 points pour Georgia W. Tush. Elle approche le peloton et c'est Ochit qu'on prend en chèvre. Ochit caught at the back as a goat. We're not seeing that much anymore.
No.
But when it works, it's quite effective.
It is. Charm City is definitely employing a somewhat small tactic of just holding position. And I think a lot of people underrate that, where we've seen a lot of games where people are rotating and they're waterfalling and they're just repositioning over and over and over. Yeah. And Charm City just seems to kind of set up this wall and just sit and hold still, rolling ever slightly forward and just moving their own bodies, not so much their position, but just their relative weight balance. And that seems to be a very good shift, holding back Montreal just a little bit when it's most important.
But they could not hold Iron Wench for 1 second. Iron Wench picks up lead jammer status. Première jammeuse pour Montréal. C'est Iron Wench. Et Susie Powell, une troisième fois en piste. A third time on the track. She gets through. She completed her initial pass. Mais Iron Wench déjà prend ses points et elle arrêtera sûrement le jam. Oui, elle se tourne. She turns around to watch the action. She picks up 5 points, 4 points, sorry, and calls off the jam. Vous êtes toujours à ECDX East Coast Derby Extravaganza de Philadelphie en Pennsylvanie. Il y a de l'action demain. More action tomorrow. Actually, a whole day of action tomorrow.
It's a full calendar. We have it right here in front of us, as a matter of fact.
And we do.
I got to tell you, everybody, if you get a chance, you should really come to ECDX because we have games, clinics, everything, and a pool.
That's a good reason.
I highly recommend you come and check it out next year this time, but we'll let you know of some of the games you can look forward to tomorrow after this jam.
On a Meliwana en piste pour les New Kids on the Block. Et c'est I Am Pain pour Charm City. C'est I Am Pain. C'est Meliwana qui est première jammeuse, mais I Am Pain s'approche dangereusement. Getting too close for comfort. I Am Pain was getting too close for comfort, and Meliwana called off the jam.
So if you are interested, please come back here to WFTDA.tv. You're going to get the opportunity to see both Glasgow and Old Reiki once again playing against. We have then Long Island, Glasgow and Long Island, then Old Reiki versus Ithaca, Philly versus Winnie. That's going to be a good game.
Oh, yeah.
Montreal and Houston, which I'm not sure if they have met in the past.
Once in Houston.
Oh. And Atlanta, Charm City, just on this rink alone.
Oh, that'll be a good one, too. Mais on a Iron Wench, encore une fois Iron Wench pour Montréal. Et c'est qui? C'est numéro 26. C'est Jess Carroll pour la vétéran de Charm City qui est jammeuse pour les Charm City All-Stars. And Iron Wench est déjà en position de côté des points. Already scoring as Iron Wench, as Just Carol exits the pack. Iron Wench arrête le jeu après avoir pris 4 points. 4 more points for Iron Wench. Brings Montreal to 97, Charm City 36, 97 pour Montréal, 36 at Charm City.
Taking a look here at the stats provided by Ringster, we do have a few more penalties starting to accrue. There are some skaters. Smack Daddy has two, Greta Bobo and Lady J also have two on the side of Montreal. We've got just two for Holly Go Hardly, Susie Powell also as well. So we've got 10 each. If we look at a total Montreal versus Charm City, so fairly even-handed in the box.
On a Holly Go Hardly pour Charm City, qui est première jammeuse, et ça fonctionne. Meliwana pour les New Kids on the Block. Et les deux jammeuses sont maintenant en position de compter des points. Le peloton à l'avant, on a les New Kids qui, évidemment, poussent la cadence. Et oh, est-ce que Holly Go Hardly prendra des points? Il y a 2 points pour Holly Go Hardly. Ça veut dire qu'elle a dépassé une blocker. She passed one blocker and she got the ghost point from the box.
Smack Daddy having a quick bit of a discussion there with the referee, just kind of looking, just kind of waiting to see what the response was going to be. I would not be surprised if Smack Daddy were doing that.
Well, basically that's all she's allowed to do in this situation.
And does it very well. It is
she
obvious.
She speaks with her eyes. An Iron Wench. Oh, Iron Wench, qui se fait presque prendre. She almost gets caught cutting the track by I Am Pain. Quelle stratégie. I Am Pain en profite pour prendre l'avance. Et Iron Wench est prise derrière un mur de Charm City, mais elle n'en fait qu'une seule bouchée. Non, c'est quand même I Am Pain qui prend les devants et devient première jammeuse. On pousse Iron Wench au tapis de façon illégale, mais de toute façon, elle est au tapis. Elle sort de la piste. Elle doit revenir à l'extérieur. Elle doit revenir à l'arrière du peloton. Mais pendant ce temps, un grand slam pour I Am Pain, a grand slam for I Am Pain.
Very smart play from Iron Wench a moment ago there as she skid way out but stayed down, crawled in, avoiding everyone to get back up.
Iron Wench sort du peloton. Elle peut maintenant compter des points, mais je pense que I Am Pain fera un dernier passage. Exactement, elle complète son passage. 4 autres points. Ça fait 9 points pour I Am Pain. Et arrête le jam. It had been a while since Charm City had scored, it seems.
Though they are on the board currently at 48, yep. Montreal at 97. If you have some feedback for us or just how things are going in general, talk to WFTDA. That is hashtag talk the number 2 WFTDA. We're curious if you have any opinions on this matchup we've been talking about. It's a 2-to-1 ratio right now. Charm City twice victorious over Montreal. Montreal with the win last time by a 20-point team. Right now, up a little bit more. We're going to see. We have 6 minutes left to play in this half.
On a Georgia Touche versus Just Carol. Et c'est Just Carol qui est première jammeuse pour Charm City All-Stars. Est-ce que Georgia Touche sortira du peloton? Elle est à l'avant. Il y a 2 autres bloqueuses de Charm City qui l'empêchent, mais c'est complété. Et Just Carol approche le peloton. Elle facilement, elle dépasse Mac Daddy et mange-moi le cul. Elle arrête le jam après 4.4 points. C'est quick, hit him and quit him for Just Carol. I think this is Just Carol's first bout back in a long time, isn't it?
Indeed it is. And it was interesting. I know that she was definitely missed the last couple of games. That was something that we had talked about here. And I saw her as looking through the program and was very surprised. I was like, is she? Mm-hmm. I know some people were excited, wondering if she was back.
Yeah.
And indeed she is, and definitely fans grateful to see that.
On I Am Pain pour 2 grandes jammeuses, en fait. I Am Pain pour Charm City, Iron Wench pour the New Kids on the Block. Un micro peloton, 2 bloqueuses. 2 blockers only for each team. Mais c'est I Am Pain qui est première jammeuse. Iron Wench recyclée à l'arrière du peloton. Elle se fera dépasser par I Am Pain. C'est une question de seconde et c'est... Oui, c'est fait. I Am Pain complète. Non, elle est envoyée à l'intérieur par Just Bandit. Sent to the inside by Just Bandit. Cheers, recycled. And we send Greta Bobo to the penalty box. But I Am Pain prend un grand slam. 5 points for I Am Pain. Iron Wench sort du peloton. Ça veut dire que les deux jammeuses peuvent compter des points. Et oh, Jess Bandit, la seule bloqueuse en piste avec Little, 2 bloqueuses en piste, qui était très bien isolée, very well isolated. Those 2 blockers allowed I Am Pain to cruise right through.
What I'm seeing as I'm watching this game is I'm not seeing any one particular consistently effective tactic against one team or the other. It's not like you're seeing somebody going after the same thing. This is working over and over and over again. It looks like they're finding and employing something. This works for a jam or two. Then they're switching it up. Then they're bringing it back. And it's good to see that both of these are able to make those adjustments so that you don't have anybody really being able to struggle. Montreal ahead because of that opportunity with the power jam.
That's
putting
right.
them up. That's the big game we've had once so far.
And Just Carroll, encore une fois, pour Charm City. Et c'est Meliwana pour les News Kids on the Block. Just Carroll having a very good game. Première jammeuse, encore une fois, pour Charm City. Meliwana sort du peloton. Les deux jammeuses peuvent compter des points. Et encore un micro-peloton. En fait, trois bloqueuses pour Montréal et deux bloqueuses. Oh! That was a nice hit from Smack Daddy. And it looked like it came at a funky time.
She doesn't just say it with her eyes, apparently.
No, and she doesn't hit the rest, but she looks at them. But if you're a player, attention.
So as we look, penalties, again, slowly, slowly accruing. No one in any real trouble. We only have one individual who has three trips, and that is Greta Bobo on the side of Montreal. And as we see, 3 minutes left, at least two, if not three more jams in this half.
And a little mama dans son premier jam pour les News Kids on the Block. Et c'est Holly Gohardley pour Charm City All-Stars. Et Holly Gohardley au banc de punition pour avoir fait trébucher Little Mama en super jam. Lady J, on l'envoie en offensive. Et facilement, Little Mama passe le peloton pour 5 points. It's a power jam for Little Mama and the News Kids on the Block. Little Mama's first jam is a power jam. What a great opportunity to show off.
She's definitely making the attempt as the low block is what sent Charm City to the penalty box.
That's right. Little Mama, on continue. Et les News Kids on the Block ralentissent la cadence, évidemment. Free Radical, la dernière bloqueuse, trop loin. La règle des 6 mètres et elle doit la laisser passer. Ça fait 10 points, 10 points so far for Little Mama. Et on envoie Greta Bobo en avant pour ouvrir la porte. Et ça fonctionne. Little Mama n'arrête même pas de patiner. She doesn't even have to stop skating. She just breezes through the open door from Greta Bobo.
Plenty of time to continue making that pass as she stays with the power jam. Great defender when you consider four out there in black and just two in green for Montreal.
Absolutely. Greta Bobo, she may get some penalties, but she's very active in the pack. This time they send Jess Bandit. On envoie Jess Bandit pour ouvrir la porte. Et Little Mama, arrête le jam. Oui, elle était première jammeuse. Évidemment, Holly Gohardley était à son passage initial. It was Holly Gohardley's initial pass. Therefore, no points. There's a minute and a half left in this half. Montreal leading 118, Charm City 64. So we will get one more jam in.
Indeed, and as we see on our screen, just still two in the green. Very effective the last go-around. They have swapped those blockers out for on the side of Charm City.
On a Meliwana pour les News Kids on the Block. Et je pense que c'est Jess Carroll pour le Charm City All-Stars. Et c'est Meliwana. Même si elle a seulement deux bloqueuses au début du jam, elle passe la première jam. It's Jess Carroll, très bien contenu par Revolver, Smack Daddy et Chasing Amy. Et Lady J. Mais ça passe pour Jess Carroll. She picks up her initial pass, so she's able to score. On recycle Meliwana à l'arrière du peloton. Elle arrête le jam juste avant que Jess Carroll ne puisse compter des points. 2 points for Meliwana and the News Kids on the Block.
And we do have, again, time enough to line them up once more. I was going to ask you, Patrick, if I heard a moment ago in the last jam, did you use the word trebuchet?
Trebuchet?
Yes.
Tripping.
Tripping. I come from the Midwest where they build trebuchets to fling things into the air. I just wanted to make sure I wasn't like some beautifully expressive term for a whip. I was like, how glorious would that be? And instead, it's a trip.
It's a trip.
Just wanted to clarify. Thank you.
On a Iron Wench, the première jammeuse pour les News Kids on the Block. Et, oh, big pile-up at the back of the pack. Et y a pas de no penalties on that pile-up. Et c'est I Am Pain pour les Charm City All-Stars. Les deux bloqueuses, les deux jammeuses en position de compter. Mais Iron Wench arrête le jam. Est-ce qu'il y aura des points? Un point pour Charm City. 1 point for Charm City and one for the News Kids and Iron Wench. And I think that's how we finish period number one.
That is how we go into the halftime. We've seen definite control, and we're going to see some more of that as we get to the action.
Wait. Et on a Georgia W. Tush versus I Am Pain pour les Charm City All-Stars. Facilement, I Am Pain prend le statut de première jammeuse. Georgia W. Tush à cette trousse. Les deux jammeuses maintenant en position de compter des points. Both jammers now eligible to score. Il y a un mur de verre en arrière. I Am Pain arrête le jam. And I believe a late call. Yes, because Georgia W. Tush picked up 2 points. She had time to get through. I Am Pain was stopped at the very back, picked up zero.
And it looks like number two, Ochit for Charm City, pays a little bit of a price to that as she was knocked down. It takes a moment or two to get back up. But thankfully, under her own power, she gets back to the bench. And as you had mentioned, both of these teams out of the gate, quick, hard hitting, hard stopping. I'm sure they've had that kind of conversation. If we're going to make a move, Charm City should start to do that now.
Ouais, on a Just Carol pour les Charm City All-Stars, c'est Iron Wench pour les New Kids on the block. À l'avant du peloton, c'est Just Carol qui pousse les New Kids. Il y a trois New Kids pour la retenir. À l'arrière du peloton, c'est Iron Wench qui pousse quatre joueuses de Charm City All-Stars. Et à l'avant, Just Carol, la dernière ligne. Wow, c'est Amanda Lashing, une recrue, a rookie for the New Kids on the block, holding back Just Carol. Just on time, it's Aaron Wench qui prend le statut de première jammeuse.
I think that was very, very well played right there. You saw Just Carol almost able to get through the front of the pack, and she gets pulled right back in.
That's right, by a rookie. Here she goes again, holding back Just Carol. But Just Carol sort du peloton. Elle peut prendre ses points, mais c'est Aaron Wench qui a déjà pris 4 points, et elle arrête le jam. Après 4.4 points for Aaron Wench, she waited on that one. I think could she be already burning some time?
Quite possibly. Free Radical, number 8 for Charm City, definitely pushing the 3-meter limit to get outside of the pack. Has to let her go.
Times two.
Wow, it's the conversion rate. Again, I'm from the Midwest, so we're definitely entrenched in inches. Trying to figure this all out.
Yes, 20 feet is 6 meters.
6 meters.
That's right. On a Meliwana pour les New Skids, et c'est I Am Pain encore une fois pour les Charm City All-Stars. I Am Pain, première jammeuse, et Meliwana sort du peloton également, les deux jammeuses. Both jammers can now score. Et on retient l'action à l'arrière pour les New Skids. Elle essaie de passer à l'intérieur. Oh! Meliwana sur I Am Pain. Est-ce qu'on aura un blocage au dos? Is that a back block? If it happens on the jammer after the call? Looks like yes, mais c'était, it was a skating out, blocking out of bounds,
yes,
I
indeed.
Believe.
Yes, indeed, that is the
on
call.
On Meliwana, so she'll be in the box. Super jam for Charm City.
Yeah, Mr. Pistol very quickly goes out there and has a quick conversation. I'm sure something along the lines of, please keep an eye on that for me. I would gratefully appreciate that, as I Am Pain takes an extra few moments with some assistance to get up, get herself back to the bench.
Et c'est Knock and Futz qui est en super jump pour les Charm City All-Stars. On la recycle à l'arrière. Il y a deux bloqueuses seulement pour Charm City et trois bloqueuses pour les New Kids on the Block. Une seule bloqueuse pour Charm City. Only one blocker left for Charm City. Mais fucking nuts, Knock and Futz, excusez-moi. Prends-les.
It is that crazy here. You know she does that intentionally, right?
Of course.
Of course.
Of course.
We appreciate so much that she does, especially as the skating ability on the track. We're glad to risk that, to watch her as she's going right now, getting around the two last warriors in neon.
Et Knock and Futz continue de compter des points. Elle a 5 points. Un grand slam pour Knock and Futz. Et seulement deux bloqueuses pour les New Skids. Et c'est Revolver et Jess Bandit. Oh, facilement. Un petit zigzag. Et 5 points pour Knock and Futz. Meliwana sort de la prison. Elle revient au jeu. Elle doit compléter son passage initial. On l'envoie à l'intérieur. Numéro 2. Ça, c'est Ochit qui envoie Meliwana à l'intérieur.
Indeed. Ochit, very nice move. Jammer comes back in, makes some contact, gets pushed all the way back, slows her up. Futz gets a good opportunity to get at least one more pass. We'll see if she can get that struggle. Two in green. Nice bit of a hustle, but the skate gave out underneath her, so she's able to get up on her feet. So we see a little bit of a run happening, just a little one,
but it
makes a difference. As Montreal right now 129, Charm City is at 83, and we're only 5 minutes in, so a nice bit of growth right there on the side of Charm City.
Et maintenant, les News Kids on the Block envoie Georgia W. Tush, la fondatrice, the founder of Montreal Roller Derby. Georgia W. Tush takes the jammer line avec, I believe that is, I Am Pain. Absolument, I Am Pain pour Charm City All-Stars. I Am Pain, première jammeuse, est-ce que? Georgia W. Tush derrière, battery operated, et ça passe, les 20 mètres, les 6 mètres sont conquis. C'est I Am Pain qui arrive derrière Smack Daddy et Chasing Amy. Elle prend ses points, elle arrête le jeu. On lui donne 3 points for Chasing Amy, for I Am Pain. 0 for Georgia Tush.
And interesting, Charm City comes out swinging. They definitely
have
more momentum, a little bit of a fire lit under them, and you can imagine why. As they went into that half, a bit of a difference there.
That's right. They swing, but they swing hard because they only have one blocker on the track.
And they definitely need to. When you look out there, I see many brilliant players from Montreal. A lot of work cut out right now for Ochit, number 2 in black.
Et c'est Iron Wench pour les New Skids et c'est Holly Go Hardly pour les Charm City All-Stars. Et on vient, You Better Work, de retour au jeu pour aider Holly Go Hardly parce que I Am Pain, parce que Iron Wench, déjà en position de compter des points, elle est dans le peloton, elle sort facilement et on lui donne 5 points, un grand slam pour Iron Wench, a grand slam for Iron Wench.
I think right now Holly Go Hardly has to be careful. She's got 4 penalties. She's got a lot of time. She can't risk building anymore, especially if she's going to be used as instrumentally right now as they're trying to.
Un beau saut, a nice apex jump from Iron Wench gives her 5 more points. She takes on the jammer. Elle dépasse la jammeuse, elle prend un autre grand slam, donc ça fait 10 points. Ouais, ça fait 10 points. We don't see that very often. She was awarded 4 points and then later on another point because she did pass the jammer after she had exited the pack.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you don't have to. And usually we see that lapping before because someone is caught up by the pack.
That's right.
But again, that was about timing. The jammer that was in the front was able to get through. She gets through as she comes back around and also has enough momentum to get past at that last moment.
Mm-hmm. Et la Georgia W. Tush pour les New Skids. Et c'est I Am Pain pour les Charm City All-Stars. Georgia W. Tush en avant. Pousse. Et ça pousse. Et ça passe. Difficilement, mais c'est complet pour Georgia W. Tush. Smack Daddy recycle I Am Pain à l'arrière du peloton. C'était presque complété. Brisé par Smack Daddy. Mais ça n'a pas été très long. Et I Am Pain sort du peloton. Mais Georgia W. Tush déjà en train de compter des points. Georgia W. Tush already scoring. Oh, open. Wide open on the inside. Picks up 4 points. It calls off the jam.
When I'm looking at penalties right now, they are starting to build. We talk Charm City's coming out a little bit more aggressively. And it is showing.
Yeah.
Penalty heavy on Charm. Yuvetta Works already up to 4. Holly Go Hardly, as before mentioned, has 4. Ochit with 3. Free Radical with 3. The only person with 3 is Greta Bobo on Montreal's side, and Lady J, though, up to 4. And what's interesting is, as we've been watching, she hasn't been making a lot of big plays, but they have been adding up, and they have been also costing her from that side.
On a knock and futz pour les Charm City All-Stars et Iron Wench pour les New Skids on the Block. À l'avant du peloton, il n'y a personne à l'avant du peloton, à part des bloqueuses. Iron Wench et knock and futz, toutes les deux recyclées à l'arrière, à l'avant. Et maintenant, c'est Nogan Fonts qui pousse sur Little Mama et demande the lashing. Et Iron Wench passe à l'intérieur. Première jammeuse, Iron Wench pour les New Skids on the Block. Nogan Fonts toujours dans le peloton, still in the pack. Nogan Fonts, Iron Wench's lead jammer. Et Nogan Fonts toujours aux prises avec 3 bloqueuses de Montréal. C'est Revolver, Little Mama et demande the lashing. Jess Bandit is goaded, but I think she was sitting back there thinking that she would open up the door for Iron Wench, and opened up the door, she does. Iron Wench, 5 points, un grand slam pour Iron Wench. Toujours dans le peloton, c'est Knock and Futz. Knock and Futz getting shut down on this one. She has never been shut down this bout, but this is the first time. Iron Wench, toujours, arrive à l'arrière du peloton, et facilement à l'intérieur, Iron Wench, 5 autres points pour les New Skids. I think the Charm City run is winding down right now.
It is, especially as now you've had a work set out for her fifth penalty. It looks like four of those have been forearm penalties. Getting a little bit loose out there.
Indeed, but Iron what is not loose is Iron Wench's gameplay. 15 points on this one. 15 points for Iron Wench. Ce jam, et ce n'est même pas un power jam, un super jam. Ça veut dire qu'Iron Wench a pris trois passages de points. 3 fois 5, 15. Les New Skids, Montreal at 156, 156 pour Montréal, 86 pour Charm City, 86 for Charm City. Il reste 20 minutes, 20 minutes left in this bout. Et on a voit I.M. Payne pour les Charm City All-Stars. Meliwana pour les New Skids on the block. Meliwana à l'intérieur, battery operated la dernière ligne et c'est passé pour Meliwana. Et I.M. Payne thrown to the ground and takes a while to get up. Et il y a deux bloqueuses, two blockers for Montreal. Au banc des punitions, c'est Smack Daddy et Cheese Grater. Ça veut dire seulement deux bloqueuses pour Montréal. Meliwana complète son passage. How many fingers? Two? Ouais, c'est deux points pour Meliwana. Ça veut dire Montréal 158, Charm City 86.
I think that Montreal definitely has their eyes on I.M. Payne. They know that she is one of the big point scorers, and they are not going to let her go. And even if it has been at the cost of a penalty or two, possibly three, they are going to stop her at every means. And it has been effective. As you had mentioned, we have 158 to 86 currently. Plenty of time to keep working it.
On Iron Wench pour les New Skids on the block, et c'est Just Carroll pour Charm City All-Stars. Just Carroll à l'avant du peloton, derrière Surgical Strike, et ça passe. Mais Iron Wench est tout près d'elle et s'apprête à la dépasser. Alors on sait ce que ça veut dire. C'est Just Carroll qui est première jammeuse. C'est trop proche, too close for comfort. She calls it off. Iron Wench forced that call. 0-0.
And again, we've been talking about how they have been working just a little bit at a time, inching forward. And I think that's the game that we're coming back to. It looks like we had some big moves, some big plays from Charm City side particularly. Now it's again, get a couple of points, end it. Get a couple of points, end it. Try to get pulling away slowly. And it looks like Montreal's on that upswing once again.
Yeah. Et encore une fois, I am Payne pulling Charm City All-Stars. Meliwana, première jammeuse pour les New Skids on the block. I.M. Payne, encore contenu par Georgia W. Tush et Little Mama. Envoyé à l'extérieur et I.M. Payne revient à l'intérieur. Georgia W. Tush était tombée, donc elle ne pouvait pas la faire reculer à l'arrière. Mais quand même, Meliwana passe à l'intérieur, prend ses 4 points, gets her 4 points and calls off the jam.
If you have anything you would like to tell us, please check us. Hashtag talk2WFTDA. I appreciate people letting me know, making sure I'm getting my words correctly. My grammar is always important. Elocution also, top of the mind. Let us know what you think is going on. Hashtag talk2WFTDA, and that is the number two.
On a Iron Wench et on a Holly Gohardley, un micro peloton, one blocker only, c'est Little Mama pour les New Skids on the block, mais quand même, Iron Wench, ça passe, c'est Holly Gohardley qui est première jammeuse. Iron Wench, à peu près 10 mètres derrière elle. Et facilement, ça passe pour Holly Gohardley. Est-ce qu'elle attendra qu'Iron Wench? Non! They keep it going. Iron Wench aussi prend 4 points, 4 points each. And Holly Gohardley carries on. Ah, là, cette fois-ci, elle prend son passage. 4 autres points, arrête le jam. 8-4 for Charm City on this one.
And it was definitely interesting as she was able to take advantage of that pass.
Yeah.
As it looked like half of the track moved out to the penalty box because there were people standing to move back in. And it was just as the jammer was coming around, she was just able to breeze through on that first pass. And then I'm surprised, in all honesty, how quickly she got right up through the middle, though the contingency of blockers from both teams was back up. They hadn't really regrouped, hadn't really had the opportunity to get together on any type of strategy.
Yeah.
Right up the middle, calls it at that moment.
Yeah, and it, you know, it's funny. It really did seem like half the pack came out of the penalty box while the other half went in. And it's reflecting on the penalty count because now we sort of have a game that we're used to. 22 minutes for Montreal, 24 for Charm City. 22 minutes de punition pour Montréal, 24 pour Charm City. You know, I was talking with, again, because I know them so well, Ewan Watarmi. She was saying that penalties were a big issue, that they were working on it. And in the game that they played against the Bay Area, they collectively had 19 minutes. And at that point, I think they were very happy because 19 minutes for a whole team is not a lot. So for them, that's working, but they've already busted that now, having picked up 22 with 16 minutes to go. Oh, boy. Et maintenant, c'est I.M. Payne qui recycle. Qui recycle Melly One à l'intérieur. She was trying to force the cut, but it didn't work because the pack actually decided to catch up to I.M. Payne. Et c'est I.M. Payne. Est-ce qu'il y a une première jammeuse? I don't think there's a lead jammer on this one.
No, there has been actually no one through
there's
the plane of the pack.
No, it hasn't been a pass. Exactly, yeah. You're right. Je pense que, I think Meliwana is becoming quite brave on this one.
And it is costing her.
Yeah, we were saying téméraire. She takes chances. Et elle s'en va au banc de punition pour un blocage haut du corps, a high block on Meliwana, center to the penalty box. That's a power jam for Charm City and Super Jam for the Charm City All-Stars. I am Payne.
Again, no one has, from a pack perspective, any real pack definition. Defensively speaking, you've got Montreal at the front, just one pivot alone doing strong defensive work.
But that's not any pivot, it's Jess Bandit. She she has been described as a one-woman wall. Et Jess Bandit continue de retenir. Non, c'est Lady J, Georgia W. Tush, qui retient I.M. Payne. Et maintenant, I.M. Payne prend 5 points awarded to I.M. Payne and the Charm City All-Stars on this power jam. Mais toujours en super jam, c'est I.M. Payne qui prend 5 points. Et maintenant, le peloton arrêté complètement. Oh, et on saute la ligne. Lady J essaie de l'arrêter. Ça ne fonctionne pas. I.M. Payne prend 5 autres points. Melly One est de retour au jeu. Est-ce que c'est son passage initial? Je pense que oui. Il n'y a pas de points. No points yet for Melly One. That was her initial pass. Little Mama recycle I.M. Payne à l'intérieur et I.M. Payne arrête le jeu.
And I think that actually worked right to the advantage of I.M. Payne. She was bumped to the inside. She had to come all the way back out, turn her completely around to see the jammer coming.
Yeah.
Very quickly calls it off. We were talking again about walls and how you had said, and I would never say this to her face because I'm sure she would prove the point, but Jess Bandit being that one-woman wall, definitely being able to decide. It seems as though that is really the strategy both of these teams are starting to use. We don't have a lot of control over the front. We don't have a lot of people lining up. It's one, two walls, a lot of sporadic maneuvering. So it's breaking up those quick runs. But still, we have Montreal getting through. Charm catching up.
On a Holly Gohardley qui est recyclé à l'arrière pour les Charm City All-Stars. Recyclé par Mange-moi le cul. Et pendant ce temps, Iron Wench prend le statut de première jammeuse. Oh! Iron Wench qui reste sur ses patins malgré s'être enfargé dans une autre joueuse. Et toujours aux prises avec son passage initial, c'est Harley O'Hardley. Iron Wench, pendant ce temps, prend 5 autres points. Ça fait 10 points. That's 10 points so far for Iron Wench in this jam. Harley O'Hardley toujours aux prises avec la défensive de Montréal. Et le passage est complété pour Harley O'Hardley. C'était difficile. Better late than never. Iron Wench approche le peloton. Est-ce qu'elle voudra prendre 4 autres points? Possiblement. Oh, et elle exécute un zigzag extraordinaire. Elle prend quand même. Oui, elle prend ses points. 4 autres points. Et n'arrête pas le jam parce que Holly Gohardley, elle aussi, est passée. Et elle prend 4 points. Holly Gohardley also picks up 4 points. I think she's just going to go in for 4 more. And then call it off. She's already got 14, though. Iron Wench prend 4 autres points. Ainsi que Holly Gohardley. They could be killing penalty time. Oh, boy. Et Holly Gohardley glisse. It seems like he slipped.
But she was having those problems. That's the third time in this jam that she has slipped at that moment.
Yeah.
Slipped undercut and I believe she did get sent to the penalty box.
She did indeed.
For that low block.
Yeah. You know what? it has been an issue for some skaters because not all leagues train on sports court. And namely for Montreal, some of the skaters are not used to skating on sports court, and it's very humid in Philadelphia, so it tends to be a little more slippery than what they're used to.
A little humid is a understatement, as we're all experiencing.
I feel just fine.
Somehow you always do, and it shows.
And a little mama au jam pour les news kids on the block en super jam. A little mama, okay. Demande un jeu numéro deux. Et c'est Demanda Lashin qui va à l'avant pour l'offensive. Little Mama prend 5 points pour les News Kids on the Block. The News Kids on the Block are a nice little run now. Et on y va. Little Mama, encore une fois, 5 autres points. You know, Little Mama likes those plays. She likes it when it's chaotic and she gets through the pack better that way. Little Mama qui demande encore un autre jeu. C'est Surgical Strike qui exécute à perfection. Little Mama, un pivot et ça passe. Little Mama, 15 points pour les News Kids on the Block. Et Holly Go Hardly sort du peloton. Elle doit exécuter son passage initial. Holly Go Hardly must execute her initial pass. So no points yet when she comes through the pack. Little Mama envoyée à l'extérieur. Et Little Mama envoyée au banc des punitions. Ça veut dire un super jam pour Holly Go Hardly et les Charm City All-Stars. Demanda Lashing recycle. Holly Go Hardly très, très loin. Elle n'a pas encore complété son passage initial. No initial pass yet for Holly Go Hardly, so she's not scoring, despite the fact that she's on a power jam. Et Holly Go Hardly toujours derrière Just Bandit et Surgical Strike. Jess Bandit recycle encore une fois Holly Go Hardly à l'extérieur. What a penalty kill this is. They wouldn't even let her complete the initial pass.
What's interesting, I wanted to respond to Ben Sherston. Hope I got your name right. You did indeed ask if we can talk a little bit about what the penalties are for. And part of the problem that we have is that we're looking not only through chain link, but through hockey fence for security's sake. Not to make any excuses, but the idea is that I want to be able to catch us up really quickly. We've been talking specifically very recently about some specific low blocks, but in all honesty, we have out of play probably being the most prevalent call for any type of penalty. I would say they're at about 25% of the total calls. Close behind that would be forearms. As mentioned before, 4 out of 5 trips for Yuveta Work are a forearm call. The other one was out of play. Looking at Free Radical, 3 of her trips for out of play as well. So I think when we talked about the little bit more aggressive style of Charm City right now, looking at that forearms, looking for out of play, looking for chasing, they're just pushing that much harder.
Yeah.
The penalties on the Montreal side are just a little bit more spread out, a little bit less as though they're trying to work to catch up to push as hard, as Montreal is now 200, Charm City at 112, but they are continuing to slowly build, a little bit more aggressive from both of these teams. And as you'd mentioned, some of those because the floor is a little bumpy. It can change the texture. It definitely gets slippery, so they have to start playing differently.
Yeah.
And when they push that hard, much more likely for those infringements to happen.
Yeah. And what we're seeing now is the Montreal coach, Ewan Watarmi, going to the front, going to the center of the track, asking for a clarification on something that hopefully we will find out very soon. She was signaling the no pass, no penalty, so I wonder what that was about. And the officials are now discussing probably what she was asking about. And I wish I could read lips because I would tell you exactly what they're saying.
Oh, don't do that. Then there's one more thing that you can do much better than I ever could.
Well, is that
I know
a challenge?
That list is already so impressive, Plastic Patrick, I must tell you. So hopefully, again, we'll get some clarification for you in just a moment as we are about 2 minutes into our WFTDA brought to you Wicked Skatewear official timeout. It's about to end. We'll get back to the action.
You know, I am paying pour les Charm City All-Stars et c'est Little Mama, la jammeuse pour les News Kids qui est au banc des punitions. Ça veut dire I am paying en super jam a power jam right now for the Charm City All-Stars.
Interesting maneuver. We saw the four wall at the back. They hopped back at that last pass.
Yeah.
That one, they basically kept the gate closed until the last moment, making Montreal have to guess which direction the jammer was going to go, and it was effective.
Well, something funny happened here. As a little mama, qui voulait entrer dans le peloton et s'est fait pousser à l'extérieur par I Am Pain. Little mama est maintenant revenue au jeu. Elle doit exécuter son passage initial. Et I Am Pain, pendant ce temps, continue d'accumuler les points. C'est son troisième. Ça fait 10 points pour I Am Pain. 10 points for I Am Pain so far. Little Mama poussée à l'extérieur. Est-ce qu'elle pourra exécuter son passage initial? Il y a 4 bloqueuses, 3 bloqueuses pour Charm City qui l'arrêtent. I Am Pain encore une fois. 15 points pour I Am Pain à date dans ce jam. Yeah, and Little Mama complète son passage initial. Little Mama completes her initial pass, which may stop the bleeding. But in the meantime, I Am Pain continues de compter des points. Elle prend 4 autres points. That's 19 points for I Am Pain on this one.
I think what we've seen the last 5, 6, even 7 jams is we've seen kind of clusters happening.
Yeah.
The way that the points have started to build. So we're going to take a moment to talk to Hyman Heaven.
That's right. That last official review was Montreal challenging a call against their jammer, and the call stood as called by the referees.
Well, all right. Sometimes it's just that simple.
Et c'est Jess Carroll pour les Charm City All-Stars contre Iron Wench pour les News Kids on the Block. Les deux jammeuses, très bien contenues. Les deux jammeuses à l'arrière du peloton.
Exactly.
I was saying the two blockers are stuck at the back of the pack. It's not very often that both jammers are stuck and can just not go anywhere. Mais maintenant, on a Just Carol à l'avant du peloton, contenue par 3 bloqueuses de Montréal. Qui est première jammeuse? Je pense que c'est... Ouais, c'était Just Carol qui était première jammeuse. Iron Wench l'a dépassée. Just Carol called off the jam. Iron Wench had overtaken her.
And indeed, what we were talking about a moment ago was kind of how those clusters of points have been happening. And I think Just Carol seeing that there's no gain, there's no value at this point. When you're starting to dwindle on clock time, you've got about 6:40 to play. You can't be racing. You can't be chasing each other. You can't be going neck and neck. You have to take every opportunity to gain advantage. If you don't end it, start over. And you even in that strategy, you've got to start getting that advantage from the gate to make any kind of movement as they're trailing by 64 points.
On a knock and futz pour les Charm City All-Stars. Et c'est Meliwana pour les News Kids on the Block. Meliwana, première jammeuse. Knock and futz prise derrière Mange-moi le cul et Smack Daddy at Cheese Grater. Meliwana s'en vient pour compter ses points. Knock and futz sort du peloton. Meliwana facilement en diagonale. Prend 4 points et arrête le jam. Knock and futz, 0.
Penalties again. Slowly accruing. It's a bit of a surprise, and I'm not quite sure why I'm as surprised. I think it's because it's been a slow build. We've seen some of these players from the Charm City and Montreal side to make those big jumps. They start to slip up in the sense that they start to play a little bit loose and they start to add quickly, whereas right now it's just every time I look at this, there's another one here, there's another one there, and they're really keeping evenly paced. It looks like Charm City has consistently 1 to 2 more every time, but not in any way outpacing the playing of Montreal in regard to trips to the penalty box.
And I Am Pain pulling Charm City All-Stars. Iron Wench pulling News Kids on the Block. Iron Wench, première jammeuse. I Am Pain derrière un mur de verre, c'est-à-dire Just Bandit, Little Mama, a surgical strike. I Am Pain envoyé au tapis. Tangled up with Revolver. She takes a while to get up again. Oh, and nobody saw the person qui avait I Am Pain passer à l'intérieur. Mais pendant ce temps, Iron Wench revient à l'arrière du peloton et s'apprête à compter des points. Elle en a déjà 3. Est-ce qu'elle en prendra un quatrième? Oui, et c'est le numéro 34, Lady Kaboom, qui était rendue trop loin. On l'envoie au banc des punitions. 4 points pour Iron Wench.
We would like to again thank CruiseSkateShop.com, offering quality-tested derby gear and guidance since 2007. That is CruiseSkateShop.com, CRUZ.
On a Georgia W. Tush pour les News Kids. Et je pense que c'est Holly Gohardley Non, c'est Just Carroll. On a Just Carroll pour Charm City All-Stars. Facilement à l'avant, c'est Georgia W. Tush qui s'empare du statut de première jammeuse. Just Carroll prise derrière Chasing Amy et Cheese Grater. Chasing Amy la dernière. Cheese Grater au banc de punition. Cheese Grater on in the penalty box. Georgia W. Tush approche le peloton. Est-ce qu'elle prendra ses points? Elle est à l'avant. Oui. Elle arrête le jeu. Et est-ce qu'il y aura... Ici, Just Carroll est arrivé au dos de Smack Daddy très rapidement. Oh, it commence. It looks like it's starting to heat up here.
It does.
How should I call them? Hotheads?
Passionate.
Passionate. Much safer.
That's how I play it. Cheese Grater went to the penalty box on a multiplayer block on that last score, but Lady Kaboom, we haven't seen. Third time for the third offense of out of play.
Et on a demandé, oh, Amanda Lashing qui passe son premier jam avec les News Kids envoyés au banc de punition pour un blocage à la tête. A high block by Amanda Lashing on the first jam for the News Kids on the block. Et c'est I Am Pain qui est en super jam pour les Charm City All-Stars.
2:50 left to play.
Et ça fait 5 points pour I Am Pain. Un grand slam. Et maintenant, il y a deux bloqueuses pour Charm City All-Stars. Il y en a trois pour Montréal. On force I Am Pain à l'intérieur de la piste. C'est Lil Mama qui recule. Et Chasing Amy est là pour l'accueillir. Elle la pousse. Oui, elle la pousse à l'extérieur. Et c'est Jess Bandit, excusez-moi, qui recule très loin.
Brilliant defense once again.
Absolutely. Nice. Killing some time.
Yeah, and they are working. I Am Pain pushing her out. She's finally able to get in on the inside. But again, calls it. What else can you do at that point when you've got 2 minutes left to play?
Yeah. I think they're doing what they can and getting as many points as they can because, bam, the point differential is very important in this game. Actually, it's important in every game now because that's what rankings are based on, point differential.
Yes, and especially as we talked earlier with Alicia, the WFTDA tournaments director, that is a factor, and she was telling me that it's a 12-month cycle. Games after 12 months drop off, so it's
a continuously
evolving factor.
Et quelle manœuvre de knock and futz qui poussait face à face avec Mange-moi le cul. Et Amanda Lashing de retour au jeu, Amanda Lashing back on the track. Knock and Fun, ses premières jammeuses, Amanda Lashing, toujours à son passage initial. Et Amanda Lashing envoyée au banc de punition encore une fois. Ooh, I feel bad for her. This is her first jam with the News Kids her, as a jammer. Knock and Futz. Et pousse Smack Daddy et la pivot qui est Chasing Amy. Smack Daddy, la dernière ligne de défense pour les News Kids on the block. Et Knock and Futz, 5 points, 5 more points for the Charm City All-Stars. I think that's 10.
Yuvetta Work was able to get back out into the pack to be a little bit successful holding that wall, but she needs to be careful as she is sitting on 6 penalties. Now, we've got 36 seconds left. Charm City, though, does have all of their timeouts still.
Oh, yeah. You know they're going to be using one anytime soon. Et ça fait 15 points pour Knock and Futz. Mais maintenant, on joue de reculons. Pourquoi pas? C'est plus facile pour la jammeuse de rattraper le peloton. Smack Daddy et Chasing Amy qui empêchent Knock and Futz de compter les points. Est-ce qu'on a une punition? Oui, on a Chasing Amy au banc des punitions. Et Knock and Futz arrête le jeu. Knock and Futz calls off the jam just on time as her coach was asking her, please call off the jam quickly so I can get a timeout in and get another jam.
Asking is an interesting usage of the word. He was very adamant as she came around. And Futz was so focused, as she should be, making sure she can get around, had her head down, coming around the corner, able to hear him. You could see as she tipped up quickly as she possibly could. And then the bench very quickly responding. So as we see, we had about 1 second left. Though our clock right now says that we have concluded, we're going to make sure that indeed they were able to get that timeout in under the wire.
And the next game, if no, you are not able to see the teams waiting in the on the side of the track. We've got the Texecutioners waiting to hit the track for their warm up. They will be facing the Philly Roller Girls, the local team.
Hometown sweethearts that they are.
Yes, but I think this weekend Derby takes over Feasterville.
Oh,
so
absolutely.
We're all locals.
We're all local to the sport of Derby. Speaking of someone local, actually, if you are paying attention at home, and I know you are, we have outside pack ref is Miss Trial, and she actually is the head of officiating for MRDA. The Shock Exchange and Mass Maelstrom opened this tournament yesterday. Mm-hmm. We're very glad to have them here, glad to see her being a part of it, being able to work both sides of the fence, as it were, the gender fence, I guess we could call it.
I think many of us do.
If you have been playing announcer bingo at home, quote of the weekend so far goes to Plastic Patrick. So as we can see now, they have been able to adjust the clock. There were 3 seconds left. Either way, certainly enough to get out, get one more jam under the wire. As was mentioned, Montreal, 211 points, Charm City, 168. The thing to discuss is there a reason outside of Charm's just a dire ability to just push it and push it and push it? Is there a reason for them, other than that, to want one more jam?
Well, I think they want to try and get the point differential to be as close as possible because, you know, although there is a 50-point difference, or 40-point, almost 40-points difference, Montreal is ranked 15th, Charm City is ranked 17th. So according to WFTDA ranking, Montreal is expected to win. However, if they win by 5 points, they won't get very far ahead. If they win by 100 points, much more beneficial.
Yes, absolutely going to relate to the numbers that you had mentioned, 15 and 17, and keep that.
That's right.
At the extremes of that positioning.
Yeah. So they want to keep that, what looks like it could be a defeat, but they want to keep the points as close as possible as they could be. Et maintenant, on aura, well, how do you close up a perfectly good old derby game with two excellent jammers, Iron Wench and I Am Pain, en piste pour les deux équipes? Et c'est I Am Pain qui pousse à l'avant pour les Charm City All-Stars. Iron Wench à l'arrière du peloton, prise derrière un mur de Charm City. Et à l'intérieur, c'est Iron Wench et mais I Am Pain tout à fait derrière elle. Est-ce que les deux jammeuses vont réussir à s'engager? Oui, Iron Wench arrête le jeu. 0-0 on this one. Why go on when it's been a tiring bout for both teams and they are ahead. I think she just wanted to hoot.
Well, and as you have mentioned, one of the reasons Charm would want to continue to go on is to shrink those points. All the more reason for Montreal to not want that to happen.
That's right. That's right. They were just coming from a couple of jammer penalties, and I think they just decided to shut it down right now. Good decision on them.
Especially and when you consider that you have a couple of people at four. But when you look at Charm very quickly, Holly Gohardley was at six. You've Got to Work was at six. You've got four for Ochit. You've got four for Free Radical. So definitely some people were pushing that much harder as they go. Speaking of going, we have the wonderful Plastic Patrick heading down, actually going to get Smack Daddy for an interview.
Vous êtes à WFTDA.tv. Je suis Plastic Patrick. On est trackside à côté de la piste de East Coast Derby Extravaganza. Smack Daddy, bonjour.
Bonjour tout le monde.
Tu viens de finir un match très serré, des vieilles rivales, Charm City.
Oui, oui, une grande, grande rivalité. Donc, c'est toujours assez serré. On ne sait jamais à quoi s'attendre.
C'était votre quatrième match contre Charm City.
Oui.
2-2.
Oui.
Oui. On voyait ton... Moi, je te connais bien. Donc, je sais qu'il y a certains regards de ta part. Est-ce que ça chauffait?
Oui. Bien, moi, honnêtement, je suis le genre de joueuse qui adore ces matchs-là, où ce que tu connais les autres joueuses, tu peux essayer de vraiment rentrer dans leur... C'est beaucoup une game de tête.
Ouais.
Donc, c'est vraiment de frustrer puis de jouer avec ça. On les connaît, ils nous connaissent aussi, donc ça frustre aussi de notre côté. Fait que c'est sûr que le sang pompe beaucoup durant ces matchs-là.
Absolument.
Puis moi, j'adore ça.
Et je dois dire, en tant que spectateur et commentateur, c'est très intéressant à regarder.
Ouais.
Maintenant, demain,
Oui.
Houston.
Oui, gros match.
Gros match.
Oui.
C'est la revanche peut-être pour Houston.
Oui.
Ou la deuxième fois.
Oui, il nous manquait quelques joueuses. Moi, j'ai pas joué contre Houston la dernière fois.
Okay.
Donc, j'ai très hâte de voir. Puis, on sait pas trop à quoi s'attendre.
Ouais.
Ils ont pas beaucoup de matchs en ligne à regarder. Donc,
non.
C'est un peu un mystère. Mais nous, sincèrement, on travaille tellement fort dernièrement. On a des nouveaux entraîneurs cette année. On est vraiment dans une bonne vibe. Normalement, les Skids... Peut-être que les gens le savent, on a tendance à faire un pic durant le début de la saison puis de crasher un peu vers la fin. Mais là, on vient de rentrer dans notre pic, on est super confortable. Donc, j'ai hâte de voir ce que ça donne demain.
Oh oui, moi aussi. Finalement,
oui.
Équipe Canada.
Oui, demain
le grand
soir.
Retour demain, c'était un de tes grands moments, en fin de compte. La Coupe du monde, tu étais la joueuse du tournoi.
Oui.
Équipe Canada dimanche contre équipe USA.
Oui. Sincèrement, on rentre avec beaucoup plus de confiance cette année. On a eu un meeting ce matin, on a regardé leur roster, puis on a hâte de les jouer. Puis je pense que le derby international, en dehors des États-Unis, a beaucoup évolué. Veux pas, ça nous a pris un petit moment, là, des années à s'adapter. Mais on en regarde tellement, on mange, on chie le derby. Fait que veux pas, là, à un moment donné, on les rattrape un peu.
Absolument.
Fait qu'on a vraiment beaucoup de confiance pour demain. On va s'attendre, on s'est fait un but de vraiment... De faire beaucoup mieux qu'au World Cup.
Ben oui, à la Coupe du Monde, c'était 3-33 à 36.
Ils nous ont, oui, c'est ça. Ils nous ont battu
Absolument.
Autour de 300. On les garde en dessous de 200 minimum demain.
Oh.
C'est à voir.
Oh, attention.
Oui.
Et c'est une prédiction signée Smack Daddy.
Oui, exactement.
Merci beaucoup, Smack Daddy.
Merci à toi.
Tu peux aller commencer.
Mon petit cool down.
Ton petit cool down.
Oui.
Vous êtes à ECDX avec Plastic Patrick et Smack Daddy. On s'en va. Bientôt avec les Philly Roller Girls contre Texecutioners.
Yeah.